Shalom. My name is APM Enzio, and I'm the host of Soak in His Glory. Today, I want us to look into the Word of the Lord as we go through different kinds of midnight hours in our lives. Some, their midnight hour is about their health, which is under threat. Some, their midnight hour is about their business or their finances or their career or their family. We all have different kinds of challenges in life. No one can claim that they are without a challenge. Even God Himself, because He loves us, He has a challenge. That is not everybody that is going to get to heaven. For some are resisting His love when the Word of God has been preached to them so that they can be able to receive the salvation and appreciate the love of God, which has been displayed before us through preachers that are preaching the life that Jesus lived to pay the price for our salvation so that one day we may all get to heaven. God has a challenge. That is not everybody that is going to get to heaven because people are resisting. You know what? They are doing all this, some in ignorance, some because they sold their souls. But I've come to encourage you who's going through a challenge right now, who is in a midnight hour. I've come to say to you that you can still praise God in your midnight hour. So I'm going to talk about the midnight hour praise. Midnight hour praise. You can still praise God even when you go through that midnight hour situation. And what is a midnight hour situation? A midnight hour situation is a situation that comes in your life because normally during the midnight hours, people are asleep. You get little help, sometimes zero help. Sometimes you try this and it's not working. Sometimes you try that and it's not working. And sometimes you can make a mistake of tending to blame people when everybody else are also going through their midnight, you see. Because normally in the midnight, people are asleep. You might be awake in your midnight. You know, the Bible says that Jesus was with His disciples and He said to them, "Let us cross over and get to the other side." And Jesus Christ went to sleep. You see, when He was asleep, His disciples were faced with a roaring sea which was busy filling their boat with water. And because it was about to sink in their eyes as water was filling in, they had to go and wake up Jesus and say, "Hey Jesus, don't you care that we are about to die? We are about to perish because the boat is being filled with water over and over and over." And Jesus woke up and rebuked the sea. So Jesus Christ woke up, you know, in His midnight. You know, it was the midnight of the disciples who could not sleep in their midnight. And Jesus, in His midnight, He went to sleep and said, "You know what? I'm going to sleep. I don't care what kind of storm that is coming my way, but I'm going to sleep because I know that we are moving from this side to the other side." So I just want to let you know that you could be in your midnight hour right now. Just like Paul and Silas in their midnight hour, they chose to praise God. They chose to worship God. They chose to magnify God. Let us read in the book of Acts chapter 16. Let us hear what the word of the Lord says. Acts chapter 16 from verse 25. The Bible says, "But at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prisons were shaken. And immediately all the doors were open and everyone's chains were loosed." Here's a situation whereby Paul and Silas had to cast a demon out of one of the girls that was used, you know, to make money. You know, she was used to go around and try to tell people their problems, acting like a prophet. So she was like a false prophet kind of a girl. And Paul and Silas had to go and cast that evil spirit. They had to destroy that evil spirit. And as they went to destroy that, this is what has happened. They had to be jailed because of that. They had to go to prison because of that. So as they went to the prison, this is what happened. In the midnight hour, they had to stand up and begin to praise God and to worship God even in the midst of their situation. And hear what the word of the Lord says. It says that as they continued praising God and worshiping God, life began to change in that prison. You see, the foundation of the prison was shaken. And what happened next is was that all the chains that were used against them, they broke down. and they became people that were set free just because of their praise and because of their, you know, prayers which they were making. So I've come to ask you right now that what is it that you are doing in your midnight hour? In your midnight hour, you can turn your situation around through praise. You can praise God, you can worship God, you can magnify Him, you can exalt Him above your challenge, above your situation. I've come to encourage you right now to let you know that God is on your side and God will never leave you nor forsake you. He will never abandon those that praise Him. He will never abandon those that continue to appreciate God. Because when you appreciate Him, even in your midnight hour, God is going to turn your situation around. He will not leave you, you know, as a praiser. God is a powerful God who loves praise. God loves a cheerful praiser. Somebody that praises Him without, you know, murmuring or complaining. God wants you to praise Him. He wants you to glorify Him. He wants you to change the way you see your situation. He wants you to turn around from your situation and begin to worship Him. Look at God and see what God has done. Look at all the things that He has provided for you. Begin to count all your blessings and name them one by one. God is on your side. He will never leave you. Just like Paul and Silas in the midnight hour, He came by and He shook the foundation of their prison and all the chains were broken down. This is what God is going to do in your life. God is going to turn your situation around. It doesn't matter what is going on right now. You could be looking at your business, you could be looking at your family, you could be looking at your own health and wondering as to where is help gonna come from. But let me tell you, even when we don't have the cure, you know, even if we don't have, you know, the perfect cure for what we're going through right now, but all I know is that God is on our side. God will protect you. God will be with you. God will be there for you even when you go through what you're going through right now. All I wanted to do is that you need to stand. Don't be intimidated by your situation around you. Don't be intimidated by what actually looks like. Never let what you see put words in your mouth. All you need to do is to stand and arise and shine, for the light has come and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you because God is with you. Begin to lift up your hands even in that situation, in that midnight hour. That is an opportunity for you to be able to lift up your voice and begin to thank Him and be grateful, because God knows that that situation will not destroy you. It is what has happened actually about Lazarus, because Lazarus was still sick when they went to Jesus. When they said to Him, Lazarus, you know, is sick. Please come and heal him. And Jesus continued. The Bible says He continued and went forth. He never went to attend to the situation of a sick man. It was as if God didn't care. It was as if Jesus didn't care about Lazarus' sickness. And up until when Lazarus had to die, then God came in. And when Jesus came in, that's when Jesus came and then called out Lazarus. He said, Lazarus, come forth. This is what I've come to say to you, that you can speak to your situation. You can speak to your business. You can speak to your family, to your career, to your community, to your health. You can call out your health back. You can be able to call your prosperity back. You can be able to speak life. It doesn't matter what a situation looks like right now. It might look like God is going further and further away from helping you. But let me tell you, it is not over until God says so. Nothing will ever put a foot stop where God is still continuing to work things behind. It might look like the situation is coming to an end. It might look like it is the end of you. It might look like there will be no remedy. It might look like there will be no change. There will be no transformation. People might have told you that when you get into this situation, you will never come alright. When you get into this situation, you will never come alright. But let me tell you something. God is on your side. And God will never leave you nor forsake you. As you continue to praise God, even in these hard times, God is going to change your situation. He's going to turn it around for good. He's going to make it for good. You will be able to succeed. You will be able to make it. That dream is not going to be shut down. That dream is going to rise. That dream is going to overcome whatever obstacles that are coming your way. God is on your side. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He is your God who's gonna stand with you. He's the God that is gonna give you strength. He will give you the power you will be able to overcome. And I've come to speak to the foundations of your prison right now. I've come to declare and decree that right now, by the power of your praise in your mouth, they will be shaken and God will begin to make a way for you. And all the chains that are trying to chain you down, God is going to make them right now be broken. In the name of Jesus, I speak, I declare and decree that your life will never be the same again. God is about to change your name. People have given you names, but God is changing your name. People have, you know, determine your future. You know, people have already written you off, but God will change all these things because He's the Alpha and Omega. He is the beginning and the end. It is not over until God says so. Like Paul and Silas, they stood up and rose from the ashes of discouragement because of the chains that were, you know, hanging in their hands and their feet. And the Bible says that, you know, their prison was in the central prison of all the other cells. So it means that, you know, there was no way, you know, they could be able to come out of that situation. But God came and shook the foundations of their prison. He had set them free. He has given them life. He has given them joy, not because they were complaining in murmury, but because they were praising God. They were grateful. They were singing hymns. They were remembering what God has done. So if you want God to come through for you, and if you want God to help you, begin to appreciate what God has done for you. And as you begin to praise God and appreciate and count all the blessings, naming them one by one, let me tell you something. God is a God who loves a praiser, a cheerful praiser. God is looking for people that are appreciating Him. So I've come to say to you that do not stop praising God, even in that midnight hour situation. Do not stop praising God. Like Jesus Christ, you can rise right now and begin to rebuke the storm. You can rise and begin to rebuke your storm because Jesus Christ rose and rebuke the storm. You can say to the storm, still, be still, be still, be still. You can command it. You can command it right now. Your praise can shut down your storm. When you begin to praise God, you are attracting God into your situation, into your life. Arise and shine, for your light has come. This word is your light. And the Bible says the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. The glory is the manifestation. Because when something begin, you know, to manifest, that is what the glory is all about. That is the glory of the Lord. God is not going to leave you. He's not going to sideline you like people. He's not going to sabotage the dream that He has given you. He is God anyway. He's a good God. He's a great God. He's always by your side. And He will keep you, He will protect you, He will fight for you, He will deliver you. It doesn't matter how many people gang around you. God is going to carry you and see you through. He's a God of abundance, He's a God of grace, He's a God of mercy. It doesn't matter how many times you have sinned against Him, but every time when you repent before Him and ask Him for mercy, God, through the blood of Jesus, will wash all those sins. He will cleanse you, He will purify you and sanctify you and make you whole once again. It doesn't matter how many witches have ganged around you to curse you, to cast spells against you. But when you begin to arise and begin to praise God and worship God, your life can never remain the same. God is going to transform you. He's going to change you. He's going to elevate you. He's going to put you where your enemies never wish for you to be, because He is a God who loves His children. The Bible says God inhabits the praises of His children. It means that when you begin to praise God, God comes and inhabit. He comes and be with you. He comes and saturate your place. My encouragement for you is that be soaked in the glory of the Lord. 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 And how can you be soaked in the glory of the Lord? It's when you begin to appreciate God. It's when you begin to look at what God has done and begin to stand and say, God, here I am. I know that You are the Alpha and the Omega. My situation is like this, but I know You that You are above this. God is able to defeat whatever enemy, you know, strategy that He can use against you. The Bible says they can come in seven directions, but in one direction, God is going to scatter them. They will be coming. They will be coming in many different ways. God is on your side. All I want to encourage you is that when the enemy comes to you, raise your voice and begin to praise God. When the enemy comes to you, raise your voice and begin to praise God. When a situation looks tough, when a situation looks, you know, so complicated that you don't know what to do else, you don't know what to say, let me tell you something. You have what it takes for you to come out of your situation. And this is how you can come out of a situation. When you begin to praise God, you can come out of a situation. When you begin to glorify God, you can come out of a situation. Because when God comes, He doesn't come empty-handed. When God comes, He comes with what you desire. He comes with the peace which you need. He comes with a breakthrough which you need. He comes with the healing which you need. God is a God who loves those that praise Him. And I know that deep inside your heart, there's a longing to praise God and to worship God and to exalt Him. So I've come to urge you, to encourage you, that you can do that. You can praise God. You can worship God, just like Paul and Silas. You can stand right where you are in the situation that you are in. You can be able to stand and begin to praise God. You can be able to stand in that situation and prophesy and say, "Thus says the Lord," just like the man of God, Ezekiel, whom he was faced with the dry bones. He stood and spoke as God said to him, "Speak to these dry bones." Right now the Lord is saying to you, speak to your dry bones. I may not know what you're going through. I may not know exactly what your dry bones are, but God knows your dry bones. The enemy might come in one direction, but God will scatter them in seven directions. God knows if they come in one direction, He can scatter them in seven directions. If they come in seven directions, He can scatter them in one direction. He can give them one direction, which is a defeat direction. God will always defeat your enemies. Every time you shout unto God, every time you praise and worship God, God is going to be able to give you that power to overcome your enemy. Desire God all the time. Desire God all the time. Desire God all the time. Praise Him and worship Him all the days of your life. The Bible says Ezekiel began to prophesy. He began to speak to the dry bones, and the dry bones, you know, came together. Let me tell you something. Whatever that has been dried up and scattered, I speak to it right now, that in the name of Jesus, it shall come together. Whatever that has been dried up and scattered, God is able to bring it together. But all He depends upon is your mouth. The Bible says life and death is in the power of the tongue. They that love it will enjoy the fruit of it. What does that mean? It means that whatever that you keep on saying is what will happen one day. Don't stop saying good things about your life. Continue prophesying. Speak over your dry bones. Speak over your dry bones. Command your dry bones. Speak over your dry bones. Prophesy over your dry bones. Your life will never be the same again. Your life depends on what comes out of your mouth, because God has already made provisions. He has provided everything that you ever need in life. God has provided everything that you need. And God has put everything inside of you. Begin to speak your business. Begin to speak your marriage. Begin to speak your prosperity, your healing, your deliverance, your blessings, your breakthrough. Begin to declare and decree that. Stop saying negative things about your children. Stop saying negative things about your spouse. Stop saying negative things about your neighborhood, about your business, about your career. Speak life all the time. All you need to do is to rise and begin to shine that light. The word of the Lord is the light that you must shine in your situation. Your situation is like darkness, you know, when it is in the negative. But you need to speak the light. The light will bring life into your situation. And that light is the word of God. All you need is the word of God. When you speak the word of God, you see, when you pray, because speaking to God is praying. So Paul and Silas were not just singing, but they were also speaking to God, which is called prayer. Speaking to God is called prayer. So you can be praying, you can be speaking to God. Use the word of God. God hears His word more than any other thing. The language to reach God is through the word of God, through prayer. So when you pray the word of God, when you speak to God about His word, that is called prayer. So Paul and Silas, they were singing hymns and they were praying at the same time. So as you pray before God, as you begin to praise God, God is going to come and turn your situation around. So I've come to encourage you, to let you know that God is on your side. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He will never abandon you. He is a great God. He's an awesome God. God loves a cheerful praiser. He doesn't love people that, you know, praise Him just from, you know, from their mouth. And it is not from the bottom of their hearts. God wants you to praise Him and to worship Him from the bottom of your heart. That's what God wants you to do. So all you need to do is to rise and shine that knowledge, is to praise Him, is to magnify Him, is to glorify Him, is to exalt Him, is to lift the name of the Lord above all things. Exalt God. Let God be above your situation. Speak the word of God above your situation. Speak life, even when it looks like your situation is just death. Speak life, because life is what you need. So speak what you need. Teach your mouth, train your mouth to speak what you desire. Don't speak what people desire against you. For the Bible says, God will grant us all our heart desires. He will not give us the desires of other people, because some people, they desire that you may collapse. Some people desire that your business collapse. Some people desire that you may die out of sickness. Some desire, you know, that you wouldn't mount to anything. Some desire that you may be retrenched. But God knows your desire. Nobody desire evil against themselves. We all desire good things. Begin to, you know, prophesy into your life. Prophesy into your life. Praise God. Begin to say that God loves you. Begin to declare and decree that, because God loves you. God will never forsake you. God will never leave you. He's with you. He's your comforter. When you are in pain, He's your healer. He's your deliverer when you are in chains. So I've come to speak this word to you, to encourage you, to let you know that God is just waiting for your praise. God is waiting for your prayer. All you can do is to lift up your voice, praise God, and worship Him, because He is the Alpha and Omega. He is there in the beginning of everything, and He's there even in the end of everything, and He is there even in the middle of everything. Whatever that you go through, God is able to deliver you from it. God is able to see you through from it. God is with you when the prophetic word comes over your life. God is with you, and God is with you all the processes. He's going to see you through, and God knows what you desire, and God will bring it to pass, because our God is a generous God, is a great God. God never lacks power. He never lacks power. He's a God who's, you know, He's an almighty God. He's able to deliver. He's able to set us free. So all you need to know is that He is an almighty. He's a God of all the might. Even that power which is holding you down, God has the power to can defeat that power in your life. All you need to do is to rejoice, is to be glad in the Lord, because God will never leave you nor forsake you. Like Paul and Silas, you know, begin to praise God. Let your chains praise Him, you know, and see your chains being broken down. You know, the Bible says the foundation was shaken, you know, and also even the prison doors were open. The prison doors were open. You could be wondering and say, when are you going to come out of this life of limitation? God is with you. As you praise and worship God, God is going to make sure that the doors of your prison will be open, and you will be able to come out of that prison door. Your limitations are removed right now. As I speak to you, as you are hearing, as you are watching this message right now, your expectations are going to be awarded by God, because God knows that you are expecting good life. For the Bible says in Jeremiah 29 verse 11, the Bible says, "For I know the thoughts that I'm thinking towards you." You know, not the thoughts of evil, but the thoughts of good. You know, God is thinking good things about us. you know, good things. God is thinking good things about us. And he's about to change. He's about to change your situation. God knows what you desire, and God is going to grant you. And I believe that as you are listening to this message right now, something is being stirred up in your spirit. There is a stirring. I feel a stirring in your spirit right now that God is stirring you to begin to praise him. He's stirring you to begin to worship him, because God will never shut his ears when we praise him. God will never close his ears when we praise him. He will never close his eyes when we praise him. He watches over us. He hears our praise, and he will always make a way. He made a way for the Israelites when they had to go through the Red Sea. He made a way, and the Red Sea became, you know, split it up, and the ground became dry, and they were able to walk through. And when Egypt was coming behind them, you know, Egypt sent, you know, soldiers to come behind them. And what happened? The same sea which was open for the children of Israel to walk through in the dry ground, it became the same sea that drowned them. Because what God has given you, no one can take it back. When God says it's time for your deliverance, nobody can claim you back to prison. When God delivers you, when God takes you out of a situation, no one can take you back. People will die when they try to take you back to what God has delivered you from. People will be, you know, squandered from whatever resources, you know, which they are using against you. God will dry up the economies of those that are trying to gang up against you. He will make them poor. There are people that God is going to make them poor because they don't know what to do with their resources. They use their resources against other people. Maybe people are busy buying. You know, they are buying people against you. But let me tell you something. God is going to use the very same resources. As the Bible says, he transfers the wealth of the unrighteous, the wealth of the wicked people into the hands of the righteous. God is going to transfer whatever resources of those that are working against you. He will transfer such resources to give it to you. Because when a righteous person is elevated, there's so much joy, because they will act righteously. So I want to say this to you. Don't worry about what is happening around you. Don't worry about whatever the people are planning to sabotage you. Don't worry about that, because God is on your side. God is going to fight those that are fighting you. Because the Bible says, touch not my anointed ones. Do my prophets no harm. You are the prophet of your own life. Begin to speak. God is happy with you saying good things. He is happy when you say good things, because you are an image of God. You look like God. When you curse yourself, God is not happy about that. When you speak negative against yourself, God is not happy with you when you speak negative against yourself, because you are made in his own image. You see, God should look at you and see things happening. God is not denying us success. He is not denying us breakthroughs. He is the one that is giving us breakthroughs and success. So continue to speak positive. Continue to speak life. Speak life no matter what you go through. Speak life. Speak life. That is why if anyone tries to come against you, God will fight them, because you are made in the image of God. So I would like to encourage you right now that just like Paul and Silas, arise in your prison. Begin to declare and decree. Begin to speak life in your prison. Begin to speak life in that situation. Speak life in your business. Speak life in your marriage. Speak life over your children. Speak life over your career. Speak life over your health. God wants you to overcome what you are going through. For greater is the one that is in you than the one that is in the world. God is on your side. And he will never leave you nor forsake you. God is happy with you when you speak positive. God wants to hear your praise. God wants to hear your positive praise to God. Praise him for what he has already done. Praise him for what he's doing. Praise him for what he's about to do. Because God is going to do something fresh. Something new is about to happen. Something great is about to happen in your life. Your life will never be the same again, because God is a God who can move things from one level of glory to the next level of glory. He can move things from one level to the next level. It doesn't matter how much the situation look like. God is able to pick you from that situation and graduate you to the next level. We are living in days whereby we are confronted with this pandemic. God is there with you. He will protect you. Yes, they say it is airborne, meaning that you can breathe it anytime, anywhere, and you can catch up with that and it might strike you. But let me tell you something. God is protecting you right where you are. I declare and decree the protection of God, that you will breathe the presence of God. You will not breathe this COVID. You will breathe the presence of God. You will breathe the glory of the Lord. As you continue to praise God, you are stirring up the presence of God over your life. You are stirring up the glory of the Lord over your life. And God is going to shower you with His blessings. He will shower you with His presence, with His glory. He will protect you. He will not allow this COVID-19 to sweep you. Your dream will come to pass. Your dream will come to pass. And God will never allow this COVID-19 to touch you, because you are anointed, because you are the prophet of God. You are the prophet of God. And God wants you to rise from your ashes. God is giving you beauty from your ashes. He's giving you praise. He's giving you praise from your morning. He's giving you dancing. Begin to dance in the presence of God. Begin to rejoice, because God is on your side. The Bible says, rejoice always. And I say rejoice. Rejoice even in that situation. The word of the Lord says that count it all joy when you go through various trials. For after you've been tried, you will begin to see the blessings of the Lord in your life. When you have allowed patience to have its perfect work in your life. I've come to speak this word and to bless you right now. And I lift up my hand right now to speak life over you. I prophesy over your life. I declare and decree the blessings of God. I declare right now in the name of Jesus, you will not be in that situation forever. You are coming out of that situation. God is graduating you now. God is giving you a new name. He's giving you a testimony. He's changing your life. He's changing all that which you are going through right now. God is making a way for you where there is no way. God is turning everything for your good. God is changing everything for your good. God will see you through. God will never forsake you. God will never abandon you. People may run away. You might even run away yourself, but God will never run away from you. God knows how to protect His own. You belong to Him, child of God. And God wants you to live a blessed life. And God wants to refresh you. Your life will never be the same again. As you hold on to Him, never give up, because God is right by your side. You are called for such a time as this to praise God. All you need to do is to lift up your voice and glorify God. All you need to do is to lift up your voice and magnify Him, because God is right by your side. People have written you off, but mercy is rewriting you. God is giving you a new story. He's giving you a testimony. Right now, arise and shine from your ashes. Begin to speak life, because I see beauty over your life. I see God glorifying you, beautifying you. I see God elevating you. So arise from those ashes of discouragement. Arise and begin to glorify God and exalt Him, because He is a living God. He knows what to do. He knows you by name. He knows the number of your hair. He knows your story. He knows where you're coming from. He knows where you are. And He knows where you're getting to. God is on your side. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He is the God of abundance. He's a God of joy. He's a God of peace. He's a God of life. God is giving you life, Zoe, life, 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 abundant life above everything else. God is expecting you to praise Him. So I'm challenging right now, begin to raise that voice and praise God. Begin to raise that voice and worship Him. Magnify Him. Exalt Him. Lift up the name of the Lord. Don't be tired of praising God. Don't be tired of worshiping God. Because God is never tired blessing you. God is never tired protecting you. He's never tired shielding you. Even in the things that you are not even aware of. Right where you are, God is with you. Begin to soak in His glory. Soak in His glory. Praise God. Worship Him. Never complain. Never murmur. Never wander in your thoughts. But gather your thoughts and begin to praise God. Gather your thoughts and begin to magnify Him. Gather your thoughts and be grateful in all situations. Rejoice because God knows you. He is with you. He's going to defeat your enemies. They will come, but God will chase them. He will drive them out. He will set you free because He is God who is on your side. He is God who protects His children. He protects His beloved. He is God. He's with you and He loves you. So I've come to pray and to speak life over you. I've come to encourage you that never give up. Continue being a praiser. Praise God no matter what you go through. Glorify Him no matter what you go through. For God is on your side. God will never leave you nor forsake you. He is God that will protect you, that will keep you all the days of your life. And I've come to say these words to encourage you. Don't be discouraged. Stand up in the presence of the Lord and begin to worship Him. Begin to thank Him. Begin to appreciate because God is on your side. He will never leave you nor forsake you. My name is APM Ensu, and I'm your apostle of worship. And I've come to encourage you. May the good Lord bless you. Shalom. See you on the next broadcast.